I try to tell my beginner people is get comfortable. Okay, keep the distance consistent, and without even striking arc, work on your flow of your hand in the torch movement. We try to do this with your gloves on, just like you would be in a normal welding situation. Okay? If you don't move your hand and you just move your fingers, you've basically made yourself a 1 or 2 inch welder, which really isn't very good. You want to keep light enough pressure on your hand, firm enough grip of the welding torch, and slide your hand across the welding table. At that point, if you're comfortable with doing that, and that helps you calibrate your hands with the torch, the distance of the torch. Okay. We also want to step up. The next step we want to do is introduce some filler metal to it. Filler metal application is going to be right ahead of the TIG torch, okay, as you're moving along. And again, we're not striking an arc yet. We're just trying to get our hands calibrated with our head. It's usually in a 90 degree configuration to the TIG torch. Your TIG torch is slightly angled in a forward push motion. Never drag a torch, always push it, and you're introducing the filler metal in front of it right on the leading edge of the puddle. So we're just going to practice that. So now notice one hand is being smooth and steady, and my other hand is actually dabbing the filler metal. Okay. For beginners, the most common problem we see is they want to strike an arc and get right to it. And 90% of the time, the first thing they do when they strike an arc and attempt to add filler metal is both their hands work at the same time. Boom. And they blow the tungsten apart. Okay? They try to dip the material, they dip the tungsten. So what we're trying to do now is dissolve your hands and your brain. We want one hand doing one thing, another hand doing another thing. Okay? Dab, 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 move. Okay.